this weekend, I'm going to give you one of my knives. I think that's cool. Anyway, it's time for the pistol round. We've got SK starting on the CT side. Two players moving towards connector. Fallen, the defuse kit man with the smoke as well. Immortals moving very quickly indeed towards the B bomb site, forcing Taco to retreat.
Looks like Immortals want to just keep it straightforward and simple. But yeah, that positioning from Fox is kind of scary. Very fast rotation for him. Love that. All the pot shots. Look at the delay on the push just before he's getting hit by the pot shots. Lovely stuff. Oh my god. Lucas already the first to hit the ground. Still able to get the plant down for the team though. And we have Taco just creeping on the high ground. He is dealt with though, and this is not looking too bad here for Immortals after all. Phelps gets a kill. Very easy kill onto Fallen, but Cole, he's alive still with 2 HP. Can he actually do this?
He's got a kit. He doesn't have a smoke grenade. Is there a potential for hero defuse? Bolts is being drawn closer, and Cold has the time up the ladder. This could be a weird angle for Bolts to deal with. But Cold doesn't have enough HP, so indeed Immortals will take the pistol. Good start for the Brazilian side. Very curious to see how this plays out with Fox. It's just extra AWP power on a map such as Train. That may be very good for SK, but the start isn't. So we've got a buy coming out. It's a force buy for the CT side. Immortals going all rifles apart from steel. He will be the UMP utility man, maybe the expendable man. Although that gun is a pretty good one. But indeed, he'll be leading the charge. Got faster movement speeds with the UMP out. Oh, Fox. Could have been worse. Could have been worse.
Fox didn't even win strips. He's like, someone just threw a grenade at me. I'm just going to stand here.
HE grenades are a tombola where most of the tickets are failure.
Oh, man. Already losing quite a few players here for SK. That's unfortunate because... Cole, can he get something? No, that's really unfortunate for SK. Because it's actually really hard, oftentimes, if you're attacking the A-bomb site, to deal with all these nooks and crannies and the crevices and just... dealing with all these positions around the trains against these Zeds and Deagles can be very tough, but SK did go for engagements before those points, and they were unfortunate in getting fragged immediately. So 2-0, and SK now obviously with a full save, and it's just a case of waiting until SK are able to get the full buy-in, which is going to be in the following round.
Fallen with 2900, go with 2800. The sniper rifles are coming, and on a map such as Train, maybe Immortals won't feel compelled to upgrade most of their SMGs to rifles, which is why they've gone for a bunch of Galils early on instead of the SMGs. Bolt with a nice angle, gotta be careful though. There's grenade! Gonna take one at least. Phelps with a grenade kill as well. And this round should be reaching its conclusion shortly. Taco coming in from main. But he has a mere USP. If he can find Phelps, maybe there's an extra kill to be had.
Bomb has been planted.
And indeed he can, but he's playing the information game, he's playing to win! Lucas gets dinked, but the second dink is not there. Brofist in the Immortals' house. Buy round, though, for SK. AWP onto Fallen, Taco hasn't bought just yet.
Well, it's kind of interesting to see how Fallen plays this, because Immortals, of course, are very familiar with his playstyle. I mean, he's so dynamic, he can be absolutely everywhere. And you don't know when he's going to pick which spot. But one of the most dangerous spots that he plays is sort of the support role for the dedicated alley player, where he's able to look towards Pop Dog, he's able to look down towards team main as well as alley as well. Either way, fast play from third into the ladder. And did he just get tagged? I think he got tagged by Henny there. That's kind of ridiculous.
Of course it's Henny looking down a ladder with an AWP.
How does that make any sense? That's amazing. I love that. I love that so much.
Of course it is. Grenades being deployed. There's a lot of Immortals players around this position, and Fox off to a good start, but a crossfire is real. Electric Box is where he will fall. Fallen holding angles, got to be careful though. Immortals looking to charge, but they are heavily tagged at the moment. Finally, Box gets taken down. Henny and Steel both almost in the red, if not the red. So, this is not going to be a hard push for Immortals. They've got Steel moving towards Ivy though.
And that was the exact position I was talking about, Fallen. Look how he plays with the ladder as well, to try to get himself information to reset the situation. And Fallen's safe because Cold is watching the angle. Seal has to walk through Cold first. And, oh, Cold wasn't actually watching in the correct spot. Now that is a problem. That is a big problem. And look at what has happened. The chain reaction as Phelps finds the forward position. But these players are still so low. First can have a great angle. Takes down Phelps. Time is starting to tick. The bomb is on the ground. And the weakest player, they're both incredibly weak at this point. Henny and Steel with less than 15 health each. Not a good look for them.
They have no idea where Taco is. They were looking for Taco the entire time and he was chilling out at the very back of A. And indeed, that's the first round on the board for SK. Buy continues for Immortals though. They've got money to spend. Henny back on the AWP. This is an important early round for both teams. Henny doing disgusting things in and around the Pop Dog.
They didn't save the AWP though, I don't think so.
Let's buy another one. Oh, the CTs? Oh,
did they save the AWP?
I'm not sure.
I'm not sure that they said the AWP. But anyway, the AWP will be on Fallen. So that's the important part. That is the really, really important part. Because, again, his positioning, he's so dynamic. We're going to see a different position from him once again. Inconnector boosted up here, looking in. It's a good vantage point to try to get a frag. And they know as well that Henny's going to be trying to go for the picking base plays. So a lot of this early round shenanigans, or the early round shenanigans, will be Henny and Fallen and exactly what they're what angles they're trying to play with and how they're trying to enable their team into these bomb sites. And it's actually Steel to make a forward play in. There it is. Oh man, Fallen fires not just one, but two in team main. And that is the AWP gone for Immortals. Steel needs to make a big play.
Doing the best he can, but he's jumped over first position, so no kills for Immortals just yet. This could turn out to be a nothing run for them, which is great for the SK cash. First taking the matter into his own hands. Oh, Bolts, that timing is absolutely brutal. How do you not get tilted by that? Lucas, what do you do in a situation? He's got 50 seconds. He can still collect the bomb. I don't believe that the CTs have seen the bomb in this round just yet. But for now, he seems to be biding his time. Makes me wonder if he's going to hold on to his AK, just looking around these angles back and forth. Spotted now. But he can't get the taps into Cold Zero. A clean round from SK.
And that's the problem, is that there was no damage. That was, I think, a big part of the play that was trying to be made there right at the end, but no damage was had. In SK, they can start to walk away with things a little bit. And again, you can see the impact that Fallen has, why he's so feared on the CT side of this map. And it's perfect for SK to get to start off on the CT side. Despite losing the pistol, they're up to two rounds now. And it's Immortals who are on a save, having been broken after a mere few rounds.
Yeah, they've got a grenade to suggest an A play, maybe a smoke plant attempt by Immortals, but no real smokes around the site despite deploying two of their three smokes. Counter flashes coming in from the CT side as Immortals start to move into the bomb site. But what can they get done in this situation? Fallen keeping an eye on the long channels, but up close, going to get taken down. There goes Fallen as well. Tech Knights coming into work now. Fast trades for both sides, but that's going to leave Bolts alone. And Taco, one versus one. Bolts with little HP. Taco knows where Bolts is, but not vice versa. And Taco will put an end to that madness. An expensive round for SK, but a round nonetheless.
Yeah, just as you said, in the previous round that was clean at the very least, so that does give them the buffer to work with in that situation. But we will see the AWPs coming back into play. Fallen on one. Henny cannot afford an AWP. He's going to have to go AK-47. So we might see a different approach from Immortals, where they try to go for a set piece on the A-bomb site. I think teams usually like to try to explore that option first before they start going to the B hits or fast B set pieces.
So SK have started with two people very deep in towards the B bomb site. Often you'll find the defaults is to have one CT over towards B, but SK maybe with the potential of a fast player put 2B there. Fox getting taken down towards Pop Dog. That's going to cause a double rotation from B from SK. They know it's going to be A and they're putting everybody here to try and hold the site.
Yeah, definitely quite a predictable round from Immortals, but it's always very hard to deal with the chaos of all the smokes. Further, he is at one with the chaos, moving through the smoke, picks up one. It's a team kill coming in to even up the numbers. First left alone here, he's got the AK, switches out the UMP. Critical damage done to Bolts, but this is going to be a tough situation for him now. Using the Molotovs, he doesn't have to worry about it. In fact, finds Phelps, but Phelps finds him quicker with the AK. And that is a quick round for Immortals, and indeed, the chaos of the A bombsite set piece works out fantastically well for Immortals.
Close score between the two teams, but it's SK whose money sucks at the moment. Less than $3,000 for most people. Fur had 6k though, so he's gonna buy. He's gonna full buy with UMP. Lots of grenades, full armor, and the defuse kit for him. And his money will still be better than at parity with his teammates. So we'll see what Fur can get done in this round. There's a CZ and a few P250s. Fur playing around the site with the UMP. We have Lucas charging in with the AK. So far, so good for Fur.
Wow, the UMP, man, it hits hard apparently in Fur's hands. But still, his teammates are falling down around him. And on the train, Felt gets a great vantage point to take Fur out, leaving just two players with pistols. Sneaky calls here, finds himself a frag, but he can't pick up the AK. Traded immediately by Henny. SK looking to concede this one with only two frags so far. Can Taco make it a third frag? And he is very low. The distance, these distances, trying to frag from this distance with a P250 is not the easiest task. The smoke is helping him actually close the distance. Oh no, that could have been a free one. And then who knows what would have happened, but Immortals close it down. 5-3. And back into the buy for SK.
Fallen Assault AWPA for the time being. Just one helmet onto this CT side. No Harambe's here, bro. I'm sorry. Lots of nades for Immortals, lots of advantages to be had. SK really lacking in grenades at the moment. Three players moving through connector into the A site, and here we have the normal default from the SK side. One person towards B, Fallen charging into position. Could get himself a second if Immortals are not careful. Fox delivering now onto Bolt. Cold Zero charging through the smoke. There goes Phelps. Immortals getting crushed in this round.
Yeah, the Chaos Man, it doesn't always work to your favor. This time it's worked to SK's favor, but there's still two players left alive to do damage. That said, now just one. Henny's gone. Wow, Fox in with the triple kill in that round, delivering the defense with the rifle, which is very cool to see. And in SK, they pick up their fourth round. And Immortals, straight away, they're going to be on a save. They actually can afford a couple pistols, but beyond that, we will get a save, I think.
Second up for SK. So, just the one tech nine for Immortals. They won't have the utility of previous rounds, so this might be a meat grind around in favor of SK. Taco shoulder peeking towards the B-bomb site, dropping that Molotov. Making sure there are no quick shenanigans from Immortals. SK, they've got two into B again, but this time they're far back on the bomb site. They don't want to give up any rifles with a pick from Immortals, so they will play the ranges. They will use the advantages and try to exploit Immortals in every fashion they can. Immortals starting slow now, but most of the players are over towards B slash Popdog. With Henny towards Ivy, they could go either way.
Yeah, and in really passive positions, just looking for the range engagements. Playing retake on B, just and playing to delay. It's just looking quite good here for SK. They've got a good setup to deal with it. It's just about hitting the shots, and that is what's going to happen. As the push comes in from Immortals, they can't contest the ranges with their weaponry. Their arsenal was found inferior. And now we get another situation where Immortals, they want to buy, but they can't really buy with this level of money. So probably see another half buy. So during all of this, this is a great moment for SK to start getting a buffer, getting a situation where they can actually afford to take some losses here or there and still not have that affect their buys in the future. Because going double up is not cheap on this map.
Again, we've got the pistols for Immortals and tons of grenades. Will it be that wall of smoke plant into the A site? No, it's going to be the same one as last time. Just denying SK information, allowing them to get close on A, but they're not pushing A. And Fur might find that. He's gotten quite close to main, where Phelps might be lurking. But they know that the Immortals are not committed to this just yet. Something is up.
Oh, first got a great position there. Oh, does he know that someone's actually passed him? Oh my goodness. Oh no, he actually craters. Falls to his death, that's hilarious. So, Phelps has himself an M4 now, and he hasn't lost any health. He's got Kevlar, he's the only guy that actually still has Kevlar as well. So this is actually problematic. Almost kills Cold Zero, but frag is made. Cold Zero is at risk here, he's losing support. Still does not have the angle for Fox though. Oh, that's not a good miss. That's a bad miss.
It's a bad miss.
And now Fallen is alone in 1-on-2. How did this even happen? Just the chaos, James, the chaos.
Fur and Phelps are quite enjoying that madness in the chat. In the meantime, Fallen rotating back towards A. He was deep towards B, pushing the higher area, but here we go. He's got a kit and a smoke. Perhaps he can use the smoke to try and bait these players. There's some time on the clock, but it's not all the time in the world. This is a horrible situation to be in, and there's a fair chance he gives up an AWP if he goes for this. There's the smoke coming out. Will he go for the hero defuse? It seems he will. Can he make it? Or can they find the spray? No, oh no, he's gonna make it! He's gonna make it! That is disgusting!
How do you let that happen? Immortals, they're gonna be so disappointed after that. What on earth has happened? Immortals, that's daylight robbery, James.
That is daylight robbery, and that's daylight cratering from Fur. That looked very painful indeed. But that defuse, bro. Man.
Oh man.
Cool as a cucumber.
The focus.
I don't often measure the temperature of cucumbers, but that is how the phrase goes. Yep. Three AWPs on the map now, two of which continue on the SK side. With thin advantage at present. Lots of early grenades. Henny's taken some damage, as has Cold Zero.
It's really important too, because SK, I mean, Immortals, if they want to win this map, they have to stop SK getting a crazy, crazy good CT side. And maybe that was the point. That could be the breaking point. We'll have to wait and find out. But Immortals, at the moment, just spread out. There's no presence or pressure on Ali, actually, which does allow a much more forward setup from SK. And they're taking full liberty with that. Just having Fallen, just keeping tabs on Ali just every so often. But you can look at this deep angle from Fox. He's playing E-Box, Electric Fox, with an AWP. That is going to be quite interesting.
Yeah, he's going to be reliant on Cold Zero to protect him from the main area, which there isn't a huge presence in at the moment from the T side, but then that also makes it less likely for the hot dog push to come in. The Immortals look to be moving towards B with 45 seconds on the clock again. SK with two in B. Very unusual angles, if you will. You can see Taco's position there. Very unusual indeed. Smoke's down, so they've got things to ruin the timing of Immortals. It's going to be hard to get the counter flashes though. He'll definitely want to keep their guns out. But there's just one from Taco. He'll have a look as well. There's Phelps spotted and the bomb. That means full rotation.
Beautiful timing and great work here. Taco will sacrifice himself to die. Yeah, the chance of getting loads of kills. Oh, I was going to say all that Fur needs to do was to survive, but the rotation is already present. And the bomb is only just going down here. Look at the nades sailing in there over the top, forcing Immortals into horrible positions. Lucas and Steel, the last two men standing in the same place as well. These grenades are doing great work here for the side of SK, but that's a good catch from Steel. Finding a one versus one, the bullets run out for Lucas. And Cold, he is a ruthless man. He'll take both kills, and that'll be the defuse for SK. But it's crazy because SK had an amazing setup to defend that. Yet still, Immortals looked very good to potentially win that round. So 7-5 right now, and SK are going to be in a situation where they're playing against still a full buy, so it's far from over just yet.
Two round leads, not quite the canyon for SK. Again, Fox and Fallen, the two AWPers. Cold is a dab hand with a rifle as well, so it's not the worst thing in the world. Playing to Fox's strength is awesome as well. See if Hen1 can do good things for a site. He's headed towards Ivy with some help. Fallen's blind. Can he get out of Ivy though? Stuck behind the box for now. He's got Cold for support as per usual. Managing to back off yet more. So indeed, risks have been taken. SK almost in an aligned through the map. Halfway through A, halfway through B. Playing on their sides of the bomb sites. No forward positions, no electric box, no players close to main on this occasion. Immortals still biding their time towards Ivy with two players. Over a minute on the clock. Three smokes for them. See the latish grenades. Now forward positions. That's a lovely grenade onto Fox. Is Fox going to go for a peek here?
Dangerous waters. Dangerous waters indeed. Playing aggressively here by yourself with the AWP. The closest support is another AWP, so this will be quite interesting for Fox. That deep angle could work out great. He'll avoid the pop flash, but what on earth is he going to do now? He misses the shot. Still though, Fallen's alive and putting in work. Heavy hitting his Fur as well. And now two men have been lost for Immortals, and they have yet to get the bomb onto the site. And there's four players on the A bomb train itself from SK Gaming.
Fallen, surely he's sure to get a kill here. Oh, he's baited by the barrel, but he gets it through anyway. Lucas going down now, and it's Henny alone. Quickly dispatched off by Fallen. And an AK is collected, but a second AWP is not on this occasion. 8-5, and a pause has been called by Immortals.
Yeah, SK Gaming able to outclass Immortals in that spot, and it's good to see that the form is looking pretty good across the board. I think, I mean, Fallen is just is scarily consistent.
It's interesting the super tough spots they're putting Fox in.
Yeah, that's very true, actually, yeah.
Because, again, it's really hard to cover Fox's 6 in respect to the main position when he's focusing on the Pop Dog. And there's, I think in that situation, it's very unlikely you're going to see one person coming out of Pop and or main. So it's very, very, very interesting, that positioning.
Yeah, you basically cannot miss a shot because so many rounds, if there's, as you say, one player, it's probably a split into the bomb site. So you have to hit every shot. It's quite, I actually like that. I love that. I love the fact that perhaps they're not saying, oh, you know, you could just do the easy job, so we'll just put you over here out of the way and yeah, we'll do the big boy work.
Yeah, it's quite interesting. We'll see how it plays out in these dying rounds. 2 rounds left. Fox has rebought his AWP. For the early Molotov, stop any fast plays, counter flashes. Mortals focusing towards the B bomb site with Henny around the IV position. Fox. Oh. Bad positioning there. Body exposed before he could see anything, and he will go down for 3. Mortals capitalizing on this now, moving into the B bomb site. Bombs get taken down by Fur, but the bomb's gonna get planted early.
Positioning is not too bad here from the CTs. They've been able to get out of the connector area, and you can see how powerful that is. Taco with a good vantage point onto the frag for Steel. Now first basically by the bomb, and there are still a couple grenades left here for the SK side on this retake effort. There's one of them, one of the two. The other one's an incendiary. Going to go in for the hold right now. Relying on Taco to keep him safe and Fallen.
Ooh.
Oh, but it's so close. Henny darting in there, stealing away the kill. And now Taco is in a lot of trouble. Lucas coming in, Fallen gets the trade, but still there's Henny alive looking for the final kill, the final nail in the coffin of this round. Henny saves the day, and that is another round on the board for Immortals. And all of these rounds are so critically important against SK's CT side. This is actually not too bad of a half for Immortals so far.
Going for the hero plays, the hero defuses. It was close, but Henny's just so fast. So fast with those peaks. And again, just imagine if the previous crouch peeking nerf to the AWP didn't come in, he would be something else. Last round of the first half, SK reduced to 2 CZs, just the 1 AWP onto Fallen and some UMPs here and there. We've got a fast play from Cold Zero through to Ivy. He's going to get information very quickly for his team, but the play is fast from Immortals as well.
Yeah, there's a really fast flank coming in from Taco, so there is a time limit on this. They have to get past E-Box, and they have to get past E-Box soon. There is a player looking for the flank, actually, so that's going to help them out. It's Bolts, you can see. Oh man, Taco wins that battle with the UMP, and now Fallen is going to be working the AWP on the bomb train, but he's behind the smoke. But the pressure from Taco from the flank is still great. He's going to steal away the AK and just lock down the retreat. Good stuff here from SK so far, but they are signed to lose the fragging battles. The bomb's lost, though. Taco with some big work.
Nobody near Pop Dog at the moment. But then again, Henny and Phelps have got time to play with. They can maneuver, they can go wide and rotate and try to close the net in on these SK players. You can see Taco has abandoned the bomb. That's the one place Immortals have to go at some point, so he will reposition it, and then Immortals will have very little idea as to what's going on. But again, look at this net. They have SK cornered, unbeknownst to them. But can they find the right angles? That's the question. Fallen in the connector, focusing on the A-bomb site. Taco spotted in the meantime. Tops will take him down, assuming Fallen's towards A. What does he do?
Fallen starts to make his way through connector, and this site's so hard to attack in this position. Phelps could be absolutely anywhere. He's looking to be on for the ace right now if he's able to catch Fallen. Because Fallen will circumvent his position and get closer. Spots Henny. Now the game's been given up. They know where Fallen is. He has to hit the shots quickly. He still has no idea. Spinning around. Oh, so fast. Phelps denied the ace. Oh, for Fallen. Oh, the triple comes in. Fallen, why are you so good at this game?
9-6 in favor of SK. That was pretty dirty. Very nice stuff indeed. So we'll see if Immortals can hold things down on their CT side, but these kills were crazy.
Oh my god, how does he even see? He's in the Matrix right now.
It's rare that Henny misses a shot like that, but yeah. There we go. Fallen clutches around for his side, and they take a small lead into the next half. Small because the pistol is won by Immortals then, it can disappear very quickly. Let's see if they can do it. Cold Zero, Smoke and a Molotov. And Taco has been made the raid boss. He's picked up a Tech 9 and he's got some Kevlar as well. Fallen has bought a flashbang and dropped a Tech 9 to his teammate. So let's see if this raid boss works out. Bolts, Diffuse Kit, HE, everybody else on pistols, and they are not going to wait for SK to make their play.
Absolutely not. Lucas goes in. Oh, what is this? Lucas with two bots headshots, looking for a third one as he backpedals out of there. Somehow gets to safety, but Taco will deny him that. But still, the brick wall that is Henny exists, and they are going to be going for the rotation instead. But falling onto Phelps is not a good way to go about things either. SK just got melted.
Great start for Immortals in the second half. But now come the anti-ecos, the anti-force buys. No plant for SK in that round. That fadeaway shot was insane. That was pretty bonkers. SK have gone for the force buy, save for Fallen, who's saving. He wants AWP ASAP. Tech 9s on three of these players, Deagle as well. No grenades onto SK on their T side, so it might be quite the gauntlet run for them. They'll look to avoid the initial grenades of the Immortal side. Once those have gone, once those have passed, what is their play? Taco, the only one with a Deagle, moving towards the Ivy, looking for that range, looking for the strafe shot onto Bolts' jaw.
So just have to hold things steady now. Henny starts things off well with the forward killer into your teammate. Very nicely done. And that's going to be a great position to work from the future. I mean, it gives him all the information. It's hard to attack into that. UMP very deadly at that range. Taco is investigating, though. And he will discover nothing but death.
Chunks of death.
And the cold steel of the floor. But he's now fallen to. And SK, they've got themselves just three players left to do some damage now. And that's kind of the objective at this point. Get some damage in. And Henny's just still in this position. Oh, man. He's making some serious bank, James.
Oh, yes. Insult to injury.
Love it.
Do not collect the tickets. You are not next in line.
Henny just made so much money, James. He just aced with the UMP. I mean, okay, one kill was with the Deagle, but that is... He's got $1,300, basically.
Cameo appearance from the Deagle. Bosh. Glorious. That is magnificent. One round between these two sides. And it's likely to be zero because SK, this is a standard eco round. This round's gonna suck if you're SK. Five Glocks and one flashbang. Fallen. I think they're gonna go pop, and he's gonna just wall up the point of flash. Well, the flash is gone, and here they go. The gauntlet run, can they make it? So far, so good. It's a Glock kill for Taco. Cameo appearance from Fur. More bells being rung as well. Can they do any more damage with this non-buy?
Oh man.
The pre-fire as well. The Glock pre-fire.
I just don't
versus
even...
the full buy. Let's go.
I don't even know. Two kills, that's nuts with the Glock. That's great. That's great for SK. Some nice damage in there. And they get the AWP into play now as well. And this is a situation where it's SK, I think, definitely they'll be a little bit worse on the T side. And it's mostly just because on train, the way the AWPing works, a player like Fallen can play from so many positions and he's so good at doing it. And the setup's so strong for the SK gaming side. It's going to be harder, I think, for them to open up the map on the T side here with the AWP as they did in the first half. Now, Fallen is looking for that frag onto Henny. Oh man, it's so close. This battle, this AWP duel between these two players is so insane. Henny missing a flying Fallen. Very tough shot to make. This time he won't make it as well.
SK spending a lot of time around a pop dog at the moment, around the ladder. Phelps is close with his ump, with his UMP. Fox and Fallen towards Ivy. Fallen has chosen not to engage any further. The joust will be paused for now. No look for an entry, but Bolts is not engaging. He has an off angle. He is biding his time. 1 minute on the clock for SK. Will they start to pick up the pace?
Yeah, they got to do something at this point. They haven't found the early pick. Now it's time to go. 50 seconds. Creeping up, Ali. Oh, but I think Bolts just spotted as he faded away. A Fallen creeping. Nade's back in there, though. They're actually locking away the T's. This is very good because there's supposed to be a split happening right now, but they're staggering the push, which is definitely a good look. And you can see SK, they're changing the plan right now. They're sending Fallen all the way back, and they're going to go, I think they're going to go to B with this.
It's really difficult for SK because if they run, Phelps is going to hear them. Lucas and Bolt's close to connector. They can make the rotation. Phelps hears, he hears the sounds, but where's the rotation? There it is. Lucas and Bolt's coming in. But look at Fox. Fox is all the way at the back. He could be the key, the playmaker for them here. But the opening frags come in for SK. What's going on?
I guess they've got 10 seconds. I guess it doesn't matter. The bomb's going to go down in the nick of time. Fox didn't even need to do anything. The two entry frags were just instantaneous. I don't know how that happened for SK, but it did. And now Henny's all alone in the cold, trying to keep his fingers on that AWP, his hands filled with the glory that is the AWP. But I don't know if that's going to be on the cards right now because SK are searching. They are searching. The hounds are out. But where is Henny? Hiding in plain sight here. Very open position. He might just be able to save this, actually, by going close to the bomb. That's awesome. He's got full health as well, so.
20 for 10 is Henny.
He's pretty good at this game. So SK able to salvage around that, I think, was really awkward, to be honest. You can see, I think they had the plan to actually split onto the A bomb site, but they decided because of all the counter grenades from the CTs that if they tried to commit that play, it would be weak. And this is one of the strengths of SK. They were able to make a mid-round adjustments like that. Obviously, they didn't leave themselves with much time, but they can have a better round, even though they do lack that time. So SK 10-9, but still the buy for Immortals, still the AWP for Henny.
Four-one setup for the CT side. This is the norm. It's an interesting smoke towards E-Box from the T side. Lying Immortals information. Fox and Fallen around main for the time being. We'll stay around the Pop Dog, then Coldzera and Taco towards B. Maybe the bomb will be spotted. Unlikely though, because Steel has a passive position. More smokes being deployed in that area. Nice Molotov as well. Trying to deny as much information as possible for the CT side. No one around E-Box, nobody goes towards B. Henny missing a shot onto Fox.
That's a dangerous game to play, James. That's a dangerous game that Fox is playing. I'm going to jump across the vision of Henny right now. Well, he doesn't get fragged this time around, so looks like he came up the winner. And in SK, they're going to go back to what worked last round, that B hit.
We'll see if Fox can be as successful lurking. Two smokes down towards IB, both disappearing. He is still here for the time being. 45 seconds left, SK moving in. There's still only one CT here on the B bomb site. That's Steel. That smoke will allow him to get closer. He knows someone's behind that smoke, but no one's protecting the bomb plant, so no bomb plant for SK.
That is massive. Steel still in deep in enemy lines. And that's just, he just pulled the pin out from under them. And now there's nothing they can really do to stop this. Steel has just single-handedly collapsed this round for the SK side. That sucks if you're SK. The bomb did not even go down. That's insane.
Fallen's forced to escape. Fox is just holding off angle at the moment. 2,700 in the bank, so he can drop for a teammate if they choose to buy in the next round.
Counter-terrorists win.
Immortals moving to double figures. That resets the loss bonus of SK as well.
It's so cool when you see a play that constitutes one frag, but it's essentially you pull the linchpin out of everything and they're just gone. They're just, everything collapses after this. That's such great work from Steel. Very opportunistic play. Playing on his guts, knowing he had the timing. And now SK and Immortals are both in a spot where they don't have much money. So this is a very telling part of this matchup.
The struggle is real, as they say. Steel again alone towards B at the beginning. Standard stuff. Just one smoke out at the moment. Four players around the A-bomb site for Immortals. It seems on T-side train, Fox is the lurker while the rest of SK use their coordination, their knowledge of each other to work together. Three players towards B. Counter, Molotov, Steel. Can he be successful with a spray here? Coldzera taken down through the smoke. Nobody else committing though, but they're drawing players in. Phelps was making his way towards B, but he's going back towards A. Do they have the right read here?
Now they're going back towards B. This is madness. Absolute madness. I think this is going to end up hurting SK more than it ends up helping them. But maybe they can just get the entries like they're able to before. Steel is taking a cursory glance towards that smoke, getting very close indeed. He is definitely looking for that cheeky play, just sitting in the smoke. Very cheeky stuff indeed. Coming out right now. This looks fantastic. Steel is just, oh my god, he's just untouchable. He's untouchable this round.
These two rounds, these last two rounds have looked very difficult for the SK side, and their money is super weird. Now mostly around $2,000. $2,000. Lovely shot from Steel there. Immortals with a lead, with some money. But will they have the consistency to string some more rounds together? Still early days in this second half. Pistols for SK, no grenades. P250 on the Fallen. Apart from that, there's not much going on.
Yeah, Phelps playing the E-box here, looking for the forward kills. Looking for those frags. Had those stats. Just Glocks. Last time though, Just Glocks got two kills. And now it's Just Glocks, well, with the P250 in the mix. An upgrade. But these ranges are quite savage to contend with. Oh, there's a Glock frag. Oh my goodness, another one. What is going on? This is a bit weird.
Yeah, that's quite worrisome because the Immortals, they're not close to closing the game out at the moment. And Henny is missing some basic shots. And you have to wonder if that's going to shake his confidence. He needs to be consistent if his team are to win this. They're putting themselves into better positions to do so. This is an important round with the buy coming back out for SK. A weak buy. The grenades are not ideal.
Please, James, there's a P90. How dare you say that?
Forgive me. The P90 is here, so obviously SK are going to win the round. Tycho is the man with a plan. Could he go flying into Pop Dog with this? Will they be charging straight into the B-bomb site? And he gets angles for free, but he can't miss, he can't hit miss shots like that. Steel is going to be forced back, and then he misses again. Now the P90 is coming out into play, only briefly though. Four versus four, Phelps on the fast flank. And the SK, they haven't managed advantage for the moment, but Phelps is in a strong position, but there is a flank on him as well.
Yeah, the bomb's been collected, it has to go away. There's no, it's got a CT blocking it to B, so everybody split up. Everybody split up right now. The CTs have found two one versus ones potentially here as the bomb is planted on the A bomb site. Fallen's taking his time, but Bird, that's great work. Oh my goodness, Bird. Okay, he's just going to clean up the round by himself. Fair enough. 12-11, the scoreline as SK picked that one up. And as you said, those kills with the Glocks can previously, that's going to be adding up here. We get a double AWP purchase. All the money is now gone from the Bank of Immortals.
Yeah, Henny's missing too many shots, though. And again, he doesn't mind putting himself in unfavorable positions. Up close, he's got nowhere to hide once he misses those shot between the, that shot between the trains. Like, indeed, they have two AWPs still on a second one. But Henny really needs to deliver. We're moving into the clutch part of this map. And this is where he needs to be consistent for his side. Knows the consistent hits, not consistent misses. 21 kills for Henny at the moment. Only eight of them are, or six of them rather, in this half. Phelps around the smoke, so far so good. Henny picking up Fox as well. Phelps looking for more, but Taka will pick him up. See Lucas charging for the smoke now.
This is looking quite difficult, actually, for SK, that is. They don't really have deep positioning just yet. Four players alive still, two of which have AWPs. Bolts on the flank, everything set up right now for Immortals to have a very, very good result here. Oh, Fallen's looking for it! Fantastic stuff there, and that is something they can work from. A minute to play with, and Immortals are still being very passive as they are playing the double up, and Fallen is slowly, one by one, trying to whittle them down.
You can hear the crowd on that one. 48 seconds remain. Lucas having a look towards Ivy, trying to cancel out some options for SK. Will he make his way towards main? That's going to be quite the walk. He can't run because Cold would hear him from Cold's position. Forward looking for somebody who must be around the back, but around the back will take a different meaning once Lucas makes his way into main. Bomb's getting planted for main as well, so they're probably going to back up in his direction. There's opportunity for Lucas. He's a playmaker here. Steel needs to rotate from B as well.
This is very awkward stuff. I think Fallen's actually looking for this angle. He is. If Lucas goes a bit more quickly, he's definitely going to die here. Oh my god, is Lucas going to walk into Fallen's crosshairs? His teammates are coming quickly, and that flashbang, waiting for that flashbang was all the difference. But still, there's two more players where that came from. Taco is able to get the trade kill, and they're still playing the time of the bomb. The smoke defuse comes in with the spray. The hail of bullets is strong with the SK side, and they will close down the round to even up the score 12-12.
And this is the time where Immortals run out of cash. We are in eco territory for the Immortals side. SK, they have a chance to capitalize on their advantages. Immortals, they've called for a tactical timeout. SK have won the last two rounds, but this half has been mostly success for the CTs. How do they get back to winning ways?
It's definitely a very hard question, especially being on the CT side. You have to basically sit there. There's not much you can do as far as aggression on this map. It's not as bad as Cobblestone, but I don't think any map really will be. But it's still not the easiest thing in the world. Adding aggression probably wouldn't be too unsafe against SK, because there's a lot of spots where they don't actually go towards the alley recently. So that might be something to think about in the future. Let's see how the anti-eco goes over SK. There's been a lot of anti-ecos that have been going a little bit sideways here or there. Big forward play from Immortals into the yard as they await SK with their fancy guns.
Bolts has made his way through Ivy, but holding an angle on that for the time being. Falling, getting tagged, forced to back up. Can shoot through some of those walls. So we'll see if Bolts continues to push a bit later on again. Fox is biding his time, waiting for any would-be pushers in that direction. SK just keeping checks on all the normal map control, making sure there's no hole for Immortals to exploit. Again, Steel on his own towards the B-bomb site. Maybe we'll see Taco venture in that direction. Find out what's going on. Steel playing inside the B-bomb site. See Henny on the high ground here towards A, but who will have the superior angle? Fox spots him. Henny back, forced to back off. No rotation from the CTs. Spotting Fox a few steps into A. Looks like he's going to be the information man for a team on a full buy. Lucas is going to go and pass that AK.
This is quite awkward indeed. Bomb collected though, and the considered efforts, coordinated efforts, will make his way to B. Oh dear, what is this? Steel to Stanny. Very large and in charge up on that train. Casually getting himself a frag. Lucas has an AK as well. This is very awkward, very disjointed here for this game. Shots need to connect right now. Too much damage is being done by these pistols. Only Fur has any health to play with. And now Henny, he's on an AWP. How has this happened?
TikTok. SK, two players remain, but Cold's only on 11 HP. Immortals need to move fast because they don't have a defuse kit. The smoke is down there, baiting these players out. Henny jumping, and he will be able to do nothing. Fur and Cold remain. Maybe the AWP is salvageable. Looks like it is, as Bolts has run away in the meantime. Though he's only got a P250, he's got nothing to save. Unless he's waiting for a gun to be shot to his side by the bomb explosion. Yeah,
there it is.
There we go. Lovely stuff by Bolts. So, something salvaged from that round, and Immortals ready for a big buy now.
It's going to be very tough here for Immortals to get themselves those early run advantages. With Henny like missing some of those shots, not being as consistent, because maybe he'll lose confidence to take some of the peaks. I'm not sure if that's going to be the case. We'll have to see. But you have to worry about that situation. If Fallen's still looking for those early round picks against Yorpa being Henny, and Henny's not feeling confident all of a sudden, that could be a big edge here for SK Gaming to capitalize upon. We get a lot of smokes in very quickly as Fallen takes an aggressive angle. Oh, how does he miss that? That is so close. And that was a haircut for Henny.
Yeah, I thought he was sure to land that kill, but alas, it was not to be. Five smokes out on the map at present, four of which are on the A sites. Fox again over towards Ivy, harassing Bolts, holding an off angle. And SK spending most of the time around the pop, around the B bomb site. So if I could, there's no lurker towards main. Fox could transition into that, but I don't think that's likely at the moment. Looks like it's going to be a B play on the SK site. 1 minute 10 on the clock, again Steel in B on his own. And the Immortal side, they're looking at a late rotation the way they're currently positioned in towards A. and that Molotov that we've seen before. That's going to draw Henny towards the B bomb site. If Steel was closer, Henny could hold the low ground with the AWP. Sorry, the high grounds. But instead, he will be holding the low. SK still with four players here, and indeed Fox is on the rotation as well now.
Yeah, great positions actually here for Henny and Steel. Nice first frag. Fallen takes down Henny though. Very, very important. Steel though, this guy is just so annoying. They can't get him off the bomb site. Leaping through the smoke once again, denying the bomb plot. Moving forwards, how does he catch Fallen? This is unreal right now. This guy is causing all the problems.
Oh man.
Steel doesn't stop. Almost the ace, not quite. A quad kill, that will do. Fur is trying to get things going his way, but there's just too much to deal with. What a ridiculous round again from Steel.
That is ridiculous. But Immortals are, ooh. Actually, I was going to say they're going to have a worse buy, but look at the money on SK as well. This is very awkward territory for both teams. And the pause has been called by SK, maybe trying to figure out what the best play is. I mean, Taco is $2,000. Fur and Cold Zero could go for full buys, but Fallen 3,300. Fox on 26. What do you do in this situation? 13 to 13, very close at the moment.
Very tense indeed. You can see why Immortals are happy to play Train. They are quite adept on this map. I mean, Steel doesn't have a huge amount of frags. He's got 16 frags. It's kind of you know, middle of the table, averaging for Immortals and just in general. But his holds on the B bomb site have been beautiful. He's always able to get some damage in. There's two rounds. He's just straight up won the round by himself. That is amazing.
So an update on what SK is doing at the moment. Timeout's just expired. Fur has bought. He has essentially full bought. One of the few players that can. And the rest of the team going for Tech 9 buy. You see Cold Zero leaving 2,800 in the bank at the moment. So we've got the one rifle play. Not an all-in, not quite the all-in from SK, but again, they're one of the teams with the prowess to execute into the A sites. Be it slow, be it fast, with a bunch of Tech 9s. Cold Zero and Fallen outside main. So it looks like they may attempt a split into A, the way things are being lined up at the moment. But look at the reaction from Immortals. Lucas playing very close, and that's the one AK he runs into from Fur.
That's a big problem. That is a big problem. Fox has stolen away a FAMAS. And the interesting thing here is that they don't have to go. Oh, the acrobatics off the ladder do nothing against Phelps. Too good with the M4, and that is the gun lost. Very big play from Phelps. Not only has he killed two players, he's got the bomb. Taco's going in for the bomb there, trying to pre-fire through the smoke. Doesn't know where his opponent possibly is. Phelps, this guy, he's done so much good work here. Cold steals away, and oh, it's not over just yet. One versus three for Cold.
AWP though, going to be very, very hard. That was, well, disaster struck in that round for SK, but again, they were not completely all in. But at this point, they might be playing for overtime because their money is in a very weird place indeed. Immortals on 14 rounds. They don't have any money either. So if SK going for the buy, actually, they're bringing out three AKs. This is a huge round for both sides. If SK were to win this round, Immortals would essentially have no cash. Maybe they could afford themselves two rifles, but SK could take it over the line, 16-14. If Immortals win this round, then it's pretty much GG for them on this map as well.
A lot at stake. SK want this to be a simple 2-0. Steel will spot the bulk of the players moving in, and he will reposition as well. But there's no commitment here from SK just yet. It's a shame for them, they weren't able to find the kill onto the retreating Steel, who has caused them so much issue and so much pain. But what has happened here is that the Immortals have put two players on the B-bomb site as a response to the aggression, the initial aggression and presence that they felt, that they saw. And SK, they are leaving their options open at the moment. No Ali presence though. So how do Immortals read that situation? That's an interesting one. The time is starting to tick away, and there's a minute left to play with. SK needs to start making their move.
Taco and Cold Zero rotating towards the B-bomb site, towards the Pop Dog. Not sure if Phelps can hear them. I don't know if they're making noise deliberately. There's lots of jumping going on. The whole SK side towards B, but this time Steel is not alone. He's got Lucas in for support. They're both playing very close around the bomb site. Phelps is looking for a flank. He's running a pop as well, so SK, if they manage to get onto the bomb site, defense may be difficult. Bolts to Henny though, quite far away. 25 seconds left. SK about to play their hand.
And Lucas on the side, he's got himself good support in the name of Steel. Can they get anything? Oh, the flick is not good there for Lucas. And Steel falls flat on his face as well. And the bomb is planted. 5 versus 3. This incredibly crucial round here looks to be taken by SK. We get Immortals turning tail and running, trying to save their weapons, bring them into the next round. But will SK allow this behavior? Oh my, what just happened? Fox knife fallen?
Replay, please. I have to see that. Oh my, the stream's going to love that one.
What?
Just, that's interesting. He's been paid off, Dan. He's been paid off by, I don't know, maybe the Spanish. So Immortals, they had no choice but to turn tail and run because, again, if they get wiped out, that's pretty much GG. They've got nothing to fight with. They wanted to save with 3. They'll end up saving with 2. The AWP onto Hen 1's going to be important, but it hasn't been as effective as one would have liked, at least in his hands. So Fox... Oh my god. That is hilarious. He's like, no, I'm so sorry.
Oh man, the timing is
that
crazy.
Is the most random knife kill I have ever seen.
I think, yeah, it has to be. That is so weird. Like running backwards, that's so insane.
Absolutely random knife kill. That is awesome. Immortals timeout. How do they play around what little they have? Well, the way they do it is Steel buying a second AWP. And I mean, he delivered very well with that AWP earlier on. I don't know if they're going to have 5... It looks like Lucas is going to be on a deagle. I don't see any weapons on the floor. So I think this is the play. Double AWP, double M4, and the deagle on to Lucas. Opportunity knocks for Immortals.
For SK as well. I mean, they could have been so badly off should they have lost the last round, but they brought themselves to this point too. Some close matches today, and SK have all the nades, man. All the nades. Looks like they're going to go for the set piece onto A. Finish this with Chaos. The smokes are going to be good at denying vision for the orbs. And the play is very forward here. Fox takes the first entry frag. The deagle's gone. Phelps is gone. 3 players left with 2 orbs. This is going to be tough.
Bolt's almost taking down the bomb planter with random spray through the smoke. There goes Cold Zero. No flank for SK now. Bolt backing off just in case there's a trade frag. In the meantime, any picking falling off. Finally, the AWP coming into play. 2 orb retake here for the CTs. Versus the 3 on SK. Bolts of the M4 has to come in big for his team. He's the only man with a defuse kit as well, so he can't die too far away. That bomb continues to tick though. Bolts has a smoke as well. Can try to draw out some of these players with that smoke. He's on the ladder, but he's running out of time. That clock is ticking very, very fast. I see him making the hero play. The flashbang coming in, but can he get the defuse? There are 2 people trying to spray him down. 2 seconds, no! He will be denied. SK, match point!
Yeah, great round from Fox. Redemption after... I mean, no one can blame him for that knife kill, but redemption, 3K for him. And now SK, they're in a position where they can win this best of 3, where they can push Immortals out, and it's all on the pistols and a Mag 7 for Immortals. That is not a good place to be. No one wants to be in that place, but that's where Immortals are.
You used to see a lot of Mag 7 when Zeus was on the team.
Yeah, you did.
Maybe a lot of Mag 7.
Like that was his only 5 binds. Oh,
wow. Fur being barbecued. Oh my god, what has happened to this round? This is, it's a 4 versus 2. It's been like 10 seconds, Dan.
Nice nade from Fox though. Just expertly placed. He's been playing some bowls. And now, it's Fox and Fallen to try to save this round. And the CTs, I don't know. They must know that the bomb dropped there, but they've decided to abandon it. And so it's going to take a while for them to actually get the bomb.
It's like there was an airstrike. Is this Call of Duty? Where are the dogs? Lucas at the back of the B bomb site. Still 2 pistols on Immortals, not really in a position to capitalize on these fallen foes and pick up their weapons. You see 1 AK around the bomb. That Molotov will be a clue for the CT side. And you see Henny looking to reposition accordingly. They know where one player is, but can they be sure that both players are there?
Very tense. SK need to be incredibly clutch. They cannot let it go to overtime like this. That is not something that they can allow to happen. Luckily, Fallen is very clutch. Let's see if he can get something done for this position. The bomb is now ticking away. The CT is deciding to come in. Fallen able to escape into better positioning, but this is very scary, allowing the CTs to get so close to the bomb. Fox has to maintain presence there. Oh, Fallen's in trouble. Lucas has the angle, but somehow Fallen's still alive. Looking to get the perfect shot, hits it, and Fox picks up the frag onto Henny. A 2v1 pulse, all he has is a P250.
Oh, he's going for the hero defuse. This is the only play he can make, and no one's going to peek him. Yes, they are. Fox, of course, to finish off the match for SK, 16-14. Would you have it any other way as far as SK victory is concerned? Oh, that is brutal for Immortals. So much potential at the beginning of that round as well.
Oh, man. And it's great to see that Fox actually came in with some very highly impactful clutch frags across this this training match, despite not being the top of the scoreboard by any means. He definitely helped SK bring it over the line here today. That is insane. Immortals are so good. Henny was on point. Henny is such a wild ride in the kind of performances he can deliver. The highs are high, the lows are low.
Yeah, that was a pretty crazy game. Immortals, that is an absolute heartbreak. Just one round away. They were so close to overtime. I mean, 10 seconds, 4v2. Like, what the hell happened? I have no idea. Just people just fell over and died.
Insane, isn't
bonkers, but indeed there won't be a third map, unfortunately, between these two sides. It would have been pretty exciting to watch, but SK progress. They take down their Brazilian counterparts on this occasion with the stand-in Fox, so they will be in more action tomorrow. We are going to go to a break and then the thoughts of the analyst desk. They will see you soon.